That is the more reason why you should believe in me. You know, I was SUG president 28 years ago. Not in 1988, as they have bandied it around. 28 years ago, subsidy was not an issue. You know, but the point I'm making is, yes, if as a student leader, close to 30 years ago, I supported a policy which over the last 30 years has crippled the sector, has meant products not to be refined in Nigeria, has denied Nigerians jobs, has denied Nigerian investment and technology, has crippled a sector that would have made Nigeria today the hub of petrochemical industries in Africa. Is it right for me to now continue to support what has not worked for my country? Leadership is about pragmatism, about what has worked. So you can see that we have tried this in the last 30 years. It has killed the industry. So that is the reason why now I'm asking all those who opposed it before to now come on board, because it has not worked. It has not made our country better. It has not grown the industry. It has not created jobs. It has not helped local refining. It has made us export crude to promote jobs in Europe and Asia, not here. And like I keep making the example, Chinese once thought that by controlling the economy it would be better. They deregulated today, they are the number two economy in the world. So let us learn. Leadership is not about fixation. It's not about a fixed position. It's about what will work for your country. So that's what it's all about. So I'm also asking Nigeria not to be fixated. They should be pragmatic to know what is working for the country or what is not working.